Hello, family. This is Kakus TV. I want to preach to you the message of peace. It's a peace message I want to put across for every Ghanaian to know that it is time for election, and therefore your vote is your power, and it's your civic responsibility to vote as a Ghanaian. Please, as you are going to the polling station, don't go there to steal ballot box. Don't go there to do any sarcastic, or don't go there to destroy anything. Please, go there, vote, and come back home. You are not part of the electoral commission. You are not part of the team that count in anything. Please, vote and then come back home and wait for the result. Please, Ghana has been a land of peace. Mother Ghana has been a land of peace since from history. We came to live in peace. Our fathers came to live in peace. And we have come to meet it. Therefore, we must maintain the peace we have come to meet. Please, help me and let me help you. Let us help each other. Let's live in harmony and peace, unity. Peace is a weapon. You see, God has blessed us with peace. God has blessed us with understanding and unity. Please do not let us belittle or underestimate this gift God has given us. Because many countries and other countries are willing to live in such peace we are having, but they are not having it. They are not having it. But God has been so good to us, and then we are living in peace and harmony. We are living in understanding. So please, let's try to maintain them. Let's try to maintain them. You see, peace is a weapon. Anything original that God has produced or God has made, Satan has a counterfeit version. Let's say God produced peace. Satan said, no, then let me produce destruction, war, conflict. War and conflict will always draw us back. It wouldn't help us to progress. It wouldn't help us to develop our country. Please, we want a better Ghana. We don't want a destruction Ghana. Please, help us. Let us maintain peace and harmony in our country. You see, as I said, when you go to the polling station, go there, vote peacefully. Do not even, if possible, do not talk to anybody. But it is between you and the leader you want to vote for. Go there peacefully, vote, and come back home. Do not let any politician pollute you. Do not be polluted. Do not be corrupted. Please, your vote is your power. It is time to demonstrate your power you have. It is time for you to show them that this is your time. This is your art. This is your meaning. This is your power. You get it? Do not let any politician disturb you. Do not let any patriotic party member distract your attention. Go for the one you want. It is your power. Watch or look at whatever leader who has been in power, and then look at their potentials. Look at their potentials and their potential. If they deserve it, you vote for them. If they do not, be at home. Do not go anywhere. Be at home and then wait for the result. Do not be deceived by any politician. Do not be deceived. Do not be ever deceived. Help us, let us maintain our mother Ghana as we go out of the country. As we say, we are proud to be a Ghanaian. You see how peaceful and how beautiful and wonderful Americans had their election. Let us emulate and imitate them, for they are the ones that brought democracy to our land. Let us show them that indeed what they brought to our land, we've been able to maintain, and we've been able to cater for it very well. And we know even more than them. Let us maintain peace in our country. Let us maintain stability, peace and stability. You see, destruction and war will always take us back. Wouldn't help us to progress. Help us to progress. Do not let us to introgress. Please, please, help us. Help us. Peace is what we need. You see, God is a God of peace. That is why we call him Shalom. That is why we call him Shalom. And then what is peace at all? What is peace at all? Let me read a little bit about peace. Peace is freedom from disturbances. Peace is also a tranquility. Even in animals' kingdom, where destruction is predominant, there is peace and tranquility. Help us, let us maintain peace and order in our country. It is also a period in which there is no war. So in a period whereby there's no war, we call it peace. Please help also the police. Help also the police to maintain and to do their job better and better for us, for the beneficiaries of our children and our generation yet unborn. Please help the police. Help them so that their job wouldn't be difficult for them, because they are the ones deployed to maintain peace and order in the country. Please, they are the ones to maintain peace. Do not fight with any officer. Please show them respect. Give them the needful and the necessary respect so that they also show us same. Give and take. Let us show them respect. Let us honor them. Let us respect them. Whatever they usher us to do, whatever they tell us to do, please let us do them. So that at the end, our mother Ghana will still be, as we see, will still be, as we all know, the world know Ghana as a peaceful country. You see, one of the disadvantages of war or conflict in a country is that it drives investors away. Please, whatever we build, where we build Ghana to, do not let us drive investors away. Let us call them. Let they themselves be convinced by their own thoughts, so that they will come and invest in our country, so that our country will be a better Ghana we want. Now, peace is a weapon given to us by God, as I said. It is as a result, and then you see, peace is a weapon, and it produces happiness, harmony, friendship, calmness, quietness, silence, stillness, privacy, solitude, and seclusion. It is also a seed, and its harvest is produces happiness, enjoyment. You see, when there's peace in a country like Ghana, we always have enjoyment. See how God has blessed us during this normal times, COVID-19 era. God has blessed us so much that we can even go around without wearing those masks, without even observing the protocol, the national protocols given us by executive order. We are not obeying them, but we are still moving around. Which peace again do you want? Please help us. Help us. Now let me read to you some few scriptures concerning peace, that we may get more understanding, that it wouldn't be like everything is from our mind, but what God is also saying about peace. Proverbs chapter 12 verse 20. Deceit is in the heart of those who devise evil, but those who plan peace have joy. So anybody that plans peace have joy. Anybody that have peace is God. In the Bible says that blessed are the peacemakers. You see, if Bible is talking about peacemakers, and then you are part of the peacemakers, indeed you are blessed. Now let's read Psalm chapter 37 verse 11. But the meek shall inherit the earth. So if you want to inherit the earth, if you want to have inheritance in the earth, you must have peace. So blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall inherit the earth. Then comes Psalm chapter 119 verse 165. Great peace have those who love laws, and nothing to cause them to stumble. So anybody that obeys laws and order, God loves that particular person. So therefore, help us to maintain peace and order in our country, Ghana. Then comes Mark chapter 14, verse number 39. Then says, then he arose and rebuked. That was when Jesus was in the ship with his disciples. That was when he was asleep, when there was a great storm. He woke up and he said, storm, be still. So Jesus is a man of peace. Therefore, if the man we are imitating and then following is a man of peace, we must also be part of the peace team, of the peace campaign, so that when we preach to others, they will also imitate and then obey. Please help us to maintain peace and order in our nation. Romans chapter 8, verse number 6. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. So do not be carnal, be spiritual. Be spiritual. And being spiritual doesn't mean that being suspended in the atmosphere, being so spiritual, but it's talking about logical thinking. Be wise. Think. When you go to the police station, don't go there to cause destruction or any war or fight. Don't go there to trigger anything bad. Go there both peacefully and then come back home to wait for the result. Now, I think the last scripture I will read, Romans chapter 14, verse 17. For the kingdom of God is not eating and drinking, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. So the kingdom of God is not about eating and drinking. The eating and drinking comes when there is peace. When there's war, there cannot be eating and drinking and enjoyment as we are talking about. This called for the dining table. I learned something later about literature. That was when I was in school, we learned about the dining table. That tells us about when there's war in a country, we cannot dine. We our children cannot play. Our loved ones, we cannot meet them. But when there's law and stability, when there's peace and stability in a nation, we can meet our loved ones. We can play in a field. We can entertain ourselves. We can do whatever we want to do. But when there is war, we are hindered to all these things. Please help us to maintain law and order in the country. Now, some advantages in maintaining law and order. Some advantages when there is peace in a nation. Living in peace brings progress and development, as we all know. It also calls for God's attention. For we are living in a country obtained. You see, when we live in a country where there's peace and stability, we attract the attention of God. It calls for God's attention. And then it motivates big investors to come to the country to invest. It also kills fear and imitation from businessmen. Some businessmen, when there's war in a country, they are afraid to even invest. They are afraid to even do business in a country. But when there's peace, it drives away fear and intimidation. It gives them the zeal. It gives them the appetite for them to do business in a country. And it also helps the youth to work, to work and to do more job to aid them in their living. Now, it reduces crime and robbery. When there's peace and stability in the country, where everybody is working, it reduces crime, it reduces robbery, it reduces pickpocketing. It kills all these things. It helps us to maintain and improve in our infrastructure and development. See where God has gotten to. Our infrastructures, our good roads, our good hospitals, our infrastructures we have. When there's war, these things will be destroyed. And then recovering from war and conflict, or recovering from conflict, is not easy. It takes time. Go and ask and go and read about countries who had once tasted war before. They will tell you that it is not easy. It will take them time and sacrifice to recover whatever they have destroyed. God forbid that Ghana will go through war and conflict. Please help us to preach to one another that voting and elections is not about war. It's about electing a potential and a good leader. This is Kaku TV. Thanks to my CEO, Nana Power. Thanks to my cameraman, Joseph Kaku. And then this is Senior Captain Sonny.
Please subscribe, like,